Every once in a while, I like to talk about animes that really impacted me. Animes which stories a lot of people relate to, because those are the kind of animes that are worth talking about. It's been a while since I've done one of these anime videos where I talk about a short anime or an anime movie that I really like. And that anime today is Sayonara no Asa ni Yakusoku no Hana wo Kazaru. Really long title, and probably not the best name, but if you've noticed, long titles have been trending recently in the last few years, so hey, who am I to judge? But the English title of this movie is Makiya, When the Promised Flower Blooms, which was written and directed by Mari Okada, a female Japanese screenwriter. Which makes sense, because this movie is directed mostly to female viewers, because one of the main subjects that this movie focuses on is motherly love and the relationship between a mother and her child. Now, this is actually Mari Okada's first time directing a movie. This movie came out around the beginning of this year, so it's still pretty recent. Now, this anime is one that was somewhat relatable, okay? I mean, not entirely, because I'm not a mother, and, you know, I don't have a child, but the relationship goes both ways, and I was able to relate to the child part of the story and trying to be grateful for a mother who tries her hardest to provide for her child and loves you unconditionally. And I'm sure a lot of other people relate to the story as well, because the reviews for this anime has been nothing but positive. Most people cried at the end and almost did I, which is why I'd like to share this anime with you guys, because if an anime is able to make you cry, or at least emotional, you bet I'm gonna talk about it. Now, if you are sensitive to spoilers, I suggest you don't watch this video, because I'm really gonna dive into the anime. I mean, I'm not gonna spoil the ending, you know, I'm just gonna talk generally about it. But if you're planning to watch the movie, I suggest you stop watching the video right now. So the story is about a girl called Makiya, a girl who belongs to a clan in which all the members stop aging in their mid-teens. You know, they stop aging around 13 to 15, and you know, they are able to live young for centuries. Now, Makiya is an orphan and, you know, never had parents. Even though she is in a clan full of friends and people, she always felt alone because she doesn't have a family. And then one day, all of a sudden, an army invades her clan, seeking the secret that grants them long life. Makiya manages to escape, but loses her friends, loved ones, and her home in the chaos. As she was wandering alone in the forest, she then encounters an orphan baby, who is also alone, whose mother was killed by robbers. So Makiya related to the baby's situation of being alone, and decided to adopt the baby as her son. Now, Makiya then raises the baby Ariel, but the only problem with that is that Ariel grows to be an adult, whereas Makiya doesn't age a single day. And the entire story is about a loving relationship between a mother and her child. Now, personally, as I mentioned, I didn't totally relate to the story because, you know, as I mentioned, I am not a parent, so I couldn't relate to someone who loves her child unconditionally. But I feel like if you are a parent, a mother, most especially a single mother, I feel like you'll relate to the story a lot more. Now, obviously, this doesn't mean that I didn't feel for the characters. Okay, I definitely did. Definitely one of the best animes I've watched. It's just that I didn't really connect with it on a personal level as much as Makoto Shinkai's Your Name or Naoko Yamada's A Silent Voice. Now, the movie itself, the storyline, I felt it was brilliant. Okay, really, really good story. One thing that I kind of related to was the subject of death, losing someone you care about. Not that I've lost anyone that I care about, it, but it's something that I've thought about a lot. The feeling of being alone and losing somebody that you care about. Now, right in the beginning of the story, Makiya was told to not get attached or fall in love with anyone outside her clan, because if she thinks that she feels alone now, it'll be a lot worse then. And obviously, she got attached to Ariel, the baby. Now, I'm not gonna spoil the ending, okay? I'd rather you watch it and experience it for yourself, but this is an anime that really touched me. A lot of people did cry, most especially in the ending scene. So, emotion-wise, it's a very emotional story. One thing that I fell in love with in the movie was the animation. The animation was really, really good. It really did capture my attention, how good the visuals were. I wasn't expecting the animation to be as good as it was. I am most especially impressed by the way Mario Kada uses lighting and color to punctuate the steps of Makiya's emotional journey. I love the lighting. I love the effects they used in the anime. The film does a great job of using color to set the tone and emotional context of each scene without those choices ever feeling forced or unnatural. But obviously, if we were to compare the visuals of the movie to Makoto Shinkai Is Your Name, the movie does fall a little short when it comes to the visuals. The effects in Your Name were obviously superior. Not saying that the effects weren't good, they were actually spectacular, but compared to a movie like Your Name, the difference is pretty obvious. But it's to be expected because, you know, Mario Kada thrives on the strength of its storytelling, not its visuals. So keeping that in mind, the visuals turned out way better than expected. Overall, the anime was beautiful, and I can't recommend this movie enough, especially if you're looking to shed a tear or two. When it comes to the saddest anime I've ever watched, I think the crown has to go to Anohana. I don't think any anime has touched me more than that anime. So if you truly want to shed a tear, go watch that one. But overall, this anime was a very, very touching story. Just pretty much great writing, I feel like. For the writing, I definitely rate it around 8-9. Definitely really, really good storytelling. As for the visuals, as I mentioned, it was still pretty good. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I mean, I know it's a little bit short, but I just wanted to share my thought. And, you know, I don't often do these kind of videos, but, you know, every once in a while, it's good to, you know, change things up a bit. And if there are any anime movies or short animes that you'd think that you'd like me to review or to talk about, just leave a suggestion in the comments below. So anyways, these are my thoughts on the movie Makiya, When the Promised Flower Blooms, and I 100% recommend you will go watch it right now. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.